Mike Sullivan. I'm a former IRS agent and teaching instructor. Welcome to my YouTube station. I worked at IRS for a decade. I was the IRS, so everything I tell you, I'm telling you for being in tax defense and the IRS. I've worked thousands of cases. I've been in national news many, many times. You just go to my website and see all the information about me at 777irs.com. I want to talk to you today about what does it mean if IRS puts you in hardship or currently non-collectible? About 40% of the active cases that IRS has in their IRS collection program cannot pay their IRS debt. It's impossible. I know this as a former IRS agent. Back in my day, when I used to work cases, only 40%, 60% of the people at that time could not pay their debt. So 40% people right now cannot pay their IRS debt, who IRS is actually holding a ticket on, so to speak. So let me tell you what you need to know about the tax hardship program called currently non-collectible. If you want to apply for a tax hardship, you must apply. It just doesn't happen. And it's not called the tax hardship. It's a catchy title, but the word means currently non-collectible. Why currently? It means at this given time, you cannot pay your IRS debt. Currently non-collectible. Your case can come out later, but right now you can't. So how does this process all happen? IRS takes a 433 financial statement. You can download it online. It's a 433F form. When they get that form, they're going to want to document it. Usually they want your pay stubs and they want that financial statement, and they're going to want a bank statement from you to make sure everything's making sense. And then they will look at that, and they will evaluate that statement, usually when you're on the line. Sometime you have to go ahead and send that form to them. Some agents at the 1-800 number say, please send it to us. So what is going to happen when IRS deems you currently non-collectible? They put a freeze code on that Social Security number, which means IRS cannot take enforcement action on you at that time. That's all that means, but your case continues to build up penalties and interest. So it's great you're in hardship, but penalties and interest grow, and IRS is going to take your refund unless you change your W-4 so you don't get that. When's your case going to come back out to the field? Generally, the IRS computer algorithms reads everything and scans everything and dumps these cases back out into the field. If you don't file your return or owe up another debt, IRS is going to send this case to a former IRS agent or back at the 1-800 number, and you don't want that to happen because now you're back in the collection system. If you don't owe a lot of money, call IRS yourself. If you owe more major money to IRS, call me. I have a whole team of former IRS agents that can help you probably get into currently non-collectible or a tax hardship. Thank you.